Hi everyone, welcome back to our Spanish tutorial. So today, we are going to discuss about verbo ser y estar. People of the world, again, verbo ser y estar in English is verb to be. Okay, so now I listed some explanation so that you can really understand the difference between verbo ser y estar. Okay, so for example, if we are going to use the verbo ser in Spanish, we are talking about característica permanente. Okay, so it's a permanent character. So for example, my sentence, my example is, soy mujer. I am a woman. Okay, ako ay babae in Tagalog. So, woman, mujer, because you will always be, or I will always be a woman. So that is why we are going, you are not going to use that estoy mujer, soy mujer. Okay, so, el verbo ser, para permanente. Okay, next, origen o nacionalidad. Ay, para origen y para nacionalidad. Somos Filipinos. We are Filipino. Tayo ay mga Filipino. And then, another example, ellos son de Filipinas. They are from the Philippines. Origen. They are from the Philippines. Sila ay taga Filipinas, no? Sa Tagalog, sa ating lenguahe po. Sa Tagalog. So, ganun lang po kadali kung paano natin gamitin ang verbo ser. Okay? Next, relacion or relationship, for example. Ella es mi amiga. Ella es mi amiga. She is my friend. Siya ay aking kaibigan. O, él es mi marido. Él es mi abuelo. Ella es mi madre. Okay? Relationship. Next. Material. El anillo, it's the ring. Okay? It's the ring. Es de plata. Okay? Or, el anillo es de oro, made of gold. Or, el anillo es de plástico. También. Okay? And then, events. La fiesta es en mi casa. So, we're talking about the fiesta. The party is in my house. La fiesta es en mi casa. Okay, as you can see, all are feminino. La, article, la, fiesta, casa. We always remember the feminino and masculino, of course. En tiempo. Ay, perdón. Profesión or profession. Okay? Soy profesora. I am a professor. So, profesora porque soy mujer. If, for example, un hombre están hablando, pues soy profesor. Okay? Ako ay profesora sa Tagalog. Okay, and then also, if we're talking about tiempo, time, we are going to use the verbo ser. Hoy es lunes. Hoy es lunes. Today is Monday. Ngayon ay lunes sa Tagalog. And then, you can also, our mini board is adjustable. Okay, son las 4 de la tarde. It's 4 o'clock, okay? So, you can use that also. Verbo ser, or son las 12 in punto. It's 12 o'clock, okay? So, now, let's go with verbo estar, okay? When we are talking about a place, lugar. In Tagalog is the same, lugar. Estoy en casa o estoy en mi casa. I am in the house or I am in my house. Okay? So, estoy. You cannot say soy en mi casa. No. Estoy en mi casa. And then, estado. Okay. ¿Estás bien? Si quieres preguntar, o ¿estás bien? Okay. So, you're talking about like, what are you feeling right now? Okay. Or, estoy bien. ¿Y tú? ¿Vale? Estoy bien. I am okay. ¿Estás bien? You are okay. Emoción. Está feliz. Means happy. Está. Third person. Possible. Ella or él está feliz. Okay? Por ejemplo, mi amiga está feliz. So, ella está feliz. Okay? Acción or action. Estoy trabajando. Estoy trabajando. I am working. Estoy trabajando. This is a continuous action using the verb be. Okay? Posición or possession. Estamos de pie. Pie is standing. Like right now, what am I doing? I am standing. Estamos is nosotros. We are standing. Okay? So, I hope that it helps you, my explanation today. So, I'm going to erase this one. And then, I'm going to put the conjugation in some sentences, okay? And if you have any questions, just leave a comment down below in this video. And if you find this video very informative, please share it to your family and friends. Help me grow my channel. These are the verbs. Okay, first we have the personal pronoun, pronombres personales, and el verbo, the conjugation of each verbs, ser y estar. Okay, so first person, you means I, soy, estoy. In English, that is I am, yo soy, yo estoy. Okay, so for example, yo soy estudiante, I'm a student. Estoy feliz, I am happy. Yo estoy feliz, I am happy. Okay? And then, tú means you, second person. Tú eres, in verbo ser. Tú eres inteligente, you are intelligent. And then, tú estás aquí. Tú estás aquí. You are here. Okay? Tú estás aquí. Hablamos del lugar. You are here. Aquí. Él, ella, usted means es. Usted is second person for formal. Okay? Usted. Okay? So, es. Ella es simpática. For example, no? And then, ella está en España. Ella está en España. Lugar. Okay, so we use the verb estar. Está. Nosotros. Nosotras. We. Okay, sa Tagalog tayo. Somos. Amigos. We are friends. Somos amigos. Or, nosotros estamos casados. Okay? Estamos casados. We are married. Okay? Next. Vosotros, vosotras, second person, you. Okay? Sois. Okay? Sois de España. You are from Spain. Sois de España. Estáis juntos. Vosotros, estáis juntos. Are you together? Estáis juntos, okay? Ellos, ellas, ustedes son extranjeros. Are strangers, extranjeros. And then, están. Ellos están en el colegio, for example. Okay? So, this is how you are going to use the verbo estar and verbo ser in the sentence. So I hope that you learned something today. This is a very simple explanation, and I hope that this video will help you a lot in your learning Spanish. And please, if you find this video informative, please share it also to your family and friends, and just leave a comment down below if you have any suggestion or comments about my channel. So hope to see you again next time for more tutorial videos. Hasta luego!